A drunk teenager with access to a luxury sports car. A horrific crash. Two innocent lives lost. A bizarre punishment. Public outcry. Intrigue. Twists and turns. And of course, politics.
राजनेताओं ने जो प्रेशर पुलिस यंत्रणा पुलिस सिस्टम एक्साइज के ऊपर लेकर आए उसके बाद आज ट्रेंडिंग में पुनः है।
पुलिस अधिकारी तपास अधिकारी वो डिफॉल्टर है तो उसके ऊपर केस दर्ज होना चाहिए। उसके बाद मैंने अपने माध्यम से उनको बताया।
The Pune Porsche crash left India in shock. On the 19th of May, a 17-year-old male driver left a party, allegedly not in his complete senses. The teenager then crashed his Porsche into a two-wheeler. The horrific crash claimed the lives of two people, one of whom was out celebrating their birthday and a major professional accomplishment. Celebrations turned to sorrow as the bereaved family was hit with what many called farce in the name of justice.
यदि आपकी संतान यदि बिगड़ जाती है तो आपको वो पैसा जो है ना मिटने में कुछ समय ही लगना है, तो फिर क्या करेंगे उस पैसे का? जब खत्म हो जाना है, आपकी संतान ही आपका पैसा खत्म कर देगी तो फिर क्या करेंगे उस पैसे का? या संतान ही बिगड़ गई उस पैसे का, या तो अब जेल चले गई तो उपयोग कौन करेगा? बात तो बची हो गई ना, आपने अपनी संतान को तो बिगाड़ दिया।
The teenage driver of the Porsche was held by Pune police almost immediately after the crash that killed two people. What followed shook the entire nation. The 17-year-old, being a minor, got his first bail with just the promise of community service and a 300-word essay. Hard to believe? The drama does not stop there.
See, this is not a very difficult case according to the point of view of law. Definitely there are some emotions involved, there are some human rights violations involved, and the rash negligent driving has killed some two persons. That was very serious issue, but from the point of view of law, this is very easy case to get the bail.
In the aftermath of the horrific crash, the case turned into a Bollywood movie with millions of eyes focused on it. From allegations of connections to the underworld to attempts at trying to scapegoat their driver, the narrative has twisted and turned. The father of the so-called Porsche killer, a well-off realtor, allegedly tried to get the case against his son dismissed by influencing the probe. The family reportedly has political connections, and the grandfather has been linked to Chota Rajan, underworld don and former aide of Dawood Ibrahim. Times Now had found, and Pune police confirmed, that the family driver did try and stop the drunk teenager from driving. So what exactly happened on that fateful night of the 19th of May?
We're told that the killer brat had told his grandfather that he was going to a party with his friends who passed class 12th. He received the keys of the vehicle and a credit card as well to pay for the party. He is then said to have driven the Porsche to the pubs while his driver tailed him. And while he came out after the party at the pub, where he racked up a huge amount in a short space of time, he looked completely inebriated, which is why the driver also told his father that it would not be safe for him to drive. Sources saying that the driver had driven the Porsche out of the parking lot as well, but it was the brat who insisted on driving the vehicle, after which his father gave in. So the driver got into the passenger seat while the brat drove and his friend sat in the back.
Debate erupted over whether the 17-year-old accused should be treated as an adult or not. Times Now caught up with experts to get to the root of the row.
Parents are asking that he be tried as an adult. What would you say to the parents who've lost their young child?
Look, I agree that it's a that loss which we can't actually afford. But the thing is, ki prima facie, if a child is less than 18 years old, then definitely he comes, he is treated as a minor according to law. And if he...
Let me say it straight up. As contentious as what should be the term for abortion or the limit, what I would say is what I say in that context as well, that if it's best to fall back on science. Now, there are multiple examples where people have shown, not just criminologists, but scientists as well and biologists, that the mental and physical development does not happen to its completion before 18, and hence this demarcation of age.
It depends on whether it's a heinous offense or not. Is this a heinous offense? Well, it's resulted in death. It's not murder, but it has resulted in death. The Tirumurthy judgment of the Supreme Court is quite clear that essentially what needs to happen is that Juvenile Justice Court needs to decide under sections 15 and 19 of the Act, for the lawyers watching, and they need to decide whether the young person between 16 and 18 had the mental capacity, neurologically, cognitively, etc., to understand the consequences of the crime, to have the...
This even as protests erupted in parts of India demanding justice. Amidst all this, the real question is, why did it seem like the Pune authorities jumped into action only after a social media campaign began?